Hey guys, it's Will from AFO Anonymous. So news has just come out that Lego has ditched its for boys and for girls model. So there's friends sets, for example, that's the clear example of something that is aimed at girls and it no longer is. Now, suddenly a load of people have come out of the woodwork and gone, oh, Lego is for everyone. There's not a problem here. This isn't an issue at all. And here is why it is an issue and why you should be happy that Lego is doing this. The problem that I'm finding is that you're getting a load of people that are commenting on stuff like this, and it's picking up traction that Lego has always just been for everyone, or it's just building blocks, you know, it's not actually segmented by gender, but it obviously massively is. Like, there's even color wise you get such a specific stark contrast between sets that are for boys and for girls. The elves subline, the friends subline, as I've already said, have got some really, really bright primary colours that you just don't get in the boys sets. Purples, pinks aren't as common and aren't often shown in a theme that isn't a sub-theme of something. So Ninjago does quite well where they have a lot of colours, but it's often, oh, these are the purple bad guys, or these are the red good guys, you know. But friends and elves had, you know, loads and loads of different colours all melded together, and that's great. And then you get, going back in time, things like Paradisa. I actually have a Paradisa box here. Paradisa sets, which are presumably for girls. It doesn't say for girls, but the point is that all of these really, really nice colours, etc., are marketing themselves towards girls, and boys are inherently made to not want to buy this stuff, think it's girly. It's so outdated, and it's a great thing that Lego are getting rid of this. Now, what Lego's actually done is they've changed the four boys and four girls section on the website to be separated into passions. So you can go, oh, my kid has a passion for dragons, here are all the dragon sets. And it creates a much more even playing field for a girl who wants to play with Star Wars sets compared to a boy who maybe wants to try some of the hotel-based sets, and they come across a friend's hotel or a shopping mall or something. You get more people invested in more things. People are going to like what they like, but if boys are raised to think that hotels and malls aren't for them, then they're going to be missing out on something that they enjoy. Now, as I said before, some of the comments on this have not been great. There's a lot of people going, oh, this is performative. It's not actually impacting anyone. It doesn't really mean anything. For example, here is a tweet saying, NPR is the website that is reporting this, one of the websites that was reporting this. They said, I think at NPR is reporting too much on this type of performative gestures that don't fundamentally benefit most people in any significant way. When did they become an identity reporting channel? Now, most people in any, I think all the people obviously who are going this are adults, and they're going, oh, well, but I can buy any Lego that I want because I get to make my own choices. Children don't, like, they can't do that. Their parents will go, oh, but here's a boy's set, or here's a girl's set. It's great to give people the option to go, oh, I want to buy a toy that represents what I like. And Sky Shark, so I'm getting enthused about this if you can't tell. Sky Shark replied to that and said, dismantling harmful gender stereotypes is fundamentally helpful to most people. And they're exactly right. Now, equally, we have another comment from just a really, really clever person who said, anyway, my favourite Lego character was the ghost, so I guess they will not fire it because it has too much male or female characteristics. Essentially, what they're making is a joke that because that men appear in Lego, that when they're getting rid of gender for Lego sets, they're going to create this kind of husk of gender and character within Lego. Absolutely not true, because men and women and non-binary people should still be represented in Lego. There are LGBT characters. Everyone is Awesome set that came out recently is great. Great example for that. We're starting to get that with the Fab Five Loft Queer Eye set as well. The image they've used is from the Wolfpack sets. Now, this perfectly demonstrates what I mean about the colour and vibrancy of girls' sets versus boys' sets. Sorry, I've got the picture just here. You can see there's greys, there's blacks, there's reds. It's against kind of a sun drop. It's very dark and, you know, angry. Society won't tell girls that this appeals to them. Essentially, it obviously does. Girls would want to be you know, interested in castles in the same way that boys care about the beach and stuff like this. Like, I don't think I'm alone in thinking that. And all this is doing is letting girls and boys know that it is all right to have interests like this. That is the point. Equally, you've got someone on here saying, we're starting with doing this with Legos. That's fine. There's obviously better stuff to be doing this on. Yeah, Lego is starting with Lego. Of course they're making changes with what they make. That's a terrible argument. You're going, oh, you know, this company is only being performative because they're only changing the name of, or the theme subset of the product that they make. Of course that's what they're doing. They make their product and they want to market it in a way that is more progressive and more inclusive to what kids want. It's not for adults who are going, oh, well, you've got to have boys and girls stuff because I was born in the 80s and that's how it is. It's not. You're an idiot. anyway, I'm in the UK and it's late. That's why the lighting's so bad. I hope that, I mean, that did just become a rant, but like, I don't know. I want to hear what you think, because I feel like the only issue that I see with this is the people reacting to it and going, this is such a big deal. Or people going, oh, it's not a big deal. Why are you even changing it? It's not a big deal in the way that people think. I believe it is a big deal for children to want to be included and have the ability to have their interests included in what they see themselves being able to access. Did that make sense? I have no idea. We'll find out. Thanks for watching. Do comment, tweet at me, at If Anonymous. Regular videos will continue, or not. I don't know, maybe I'll get cancelled for this. If any big LEGO YouTubers who disagree with me want to do a debate when I've actually thought about my points, then I will happily do that as long as they come on my channel and I get a lot of subscribers out of it. Thank you for checking out this video, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.